Hey, Tennessee, John Gentry. Our forefathers used to brag that the Tennessee Constitution was the least imperfect and the most Republican. And sadly, today, half of the citizenry doesn't even know that we have a Tennessee state constitution. Here's why that is important. If we look at the preamble of the United States Constitution, it says, "We the people, in order to form a more perfect union, establish justice, ensure domestic tranquility, and provide for the general welfare of the people, do ordain this Constitution of the United States." And the Tennessee Constitution was put in place for the same reasons, to ensure the safety, happiness, and well-being of the people in Article 1, Section 1 of the Tennessee Constitution. The Constitution establishes our form of government. And the reason that we have this form of government is because our forefathers suffered tyranny. It's why we declared independence from Great Britain, for committing grievances against the people, the inhabitants of these states. And so we set up our state and federal constitutions to protect from that tyranny ever happening again. And so we have certain restrictions against government. For example, no judge shall hold any other office of trust or profit under this state or the United States. That is a constitutional mandate, that a judge cannot have a second office. And why do you think the founders put that in there? They put that into the Constitution because they know tricky attorneys in black robes will use those offices to further corruption. And so they prevented against that by prohibiting that. But we the people have forgotten the intent, the purpose, or the content of our state and federal constitutions. And as a result of that, our form of government has been fundamentally and unlawfully altered. And I'm working hard demanding that the Constitution be upheld and adhered to by our state government. And thus far, they are refusing to abolish the Tennessee Board of Judicial Conduct that has judges sitting in prohibited offices of trust. The state refuses to uphold our most powerful constitutional right of remonstrance. And so I'm fighting for all of us in our legislative houses and in our courts and raising public awareness. And I need the people beside me demanding that government adhere to the Constitution. They swear oaths to uphold and defend the Constitution. Every person that takes office takes that oath. Every person that joins the military swears an oath to defend the Constitution against enemies, foreign and domestic. So why do you think the founders had a person seeking office or persons in office swearing an oath? Why not just write a contract? It's because an oath is before God, and those oaths will be upheld by God. And so the founders put that in there as the strongest link among men. That's a legal maxim of what an oath means. It's the strongest link among men. So I ask you to stand with me and demand government return to its proper form and reestablish justice that our constitutions were put in place to maintain. Justice is a fair treatment of the people. That's a Black's Law Dictionary of justice. But we don't have any justice because our government has unlawfully and fundamentally altered its proper form in violation of state and federal constitutions. So my name is John Gentry. I'm a candidate for State Senate, District 18, Sumner, Trousdale, and part of Davidson County. And because so many people across this state have wanted to vote for me, I have registered as a write-in candidate for United States Senate. So I hope that on November 3rd, you will write in John Gentry for United States Senate and send a strong message that from the people to the government that we demand that the constitutions be restored and upheld by our government. So thank you for taking this time with me. God bless, Godspeed to us all, and in God we trust.